What's up guys, I'm Wajahat Ahmad and this is our new tutorial on networking. We are going to show you how you can connect two PCs with each other by using a LAN cable.
Let me first introduce you myself. I'm Waqas Ahmad, Wajahat YouTube's partner, and today we are working on a tutorial and I'm helping Wajahat Ahmad on his networking tutorial. So we have two laptops, Fujitsu and IBM. Both have a Windows 7 operating system. 64-bit operating systems installed, and there is also a networking cable. Of course, we will do the networking sharing via a networking cable.
Now we are going to connect the LAN cable with one PC like this. Make sure it is connected perfectly, and now connect the other end with your second PC like this.
Now I'm here at the PC1 and I want to share my E drive in my computer. So just make sure that you disable your Wi-Fi at both PCs. And to share my drives, what I would need to enter the IP settings for that. So I will access the Open Networking and Sharing Center, and then I will go to Local Area Connection, that is my LAN connection right now, as you can see. Then I will access the properties and then the Internet Protocol version 4 properties. So here you can see the five IP address are automatically set right now here, but for that and for now we need to enter the IP. And what I would enter, just make keep in mind that as we are not using internet, so that IP should not they can be valid, but it is actually not necessary. We can enter invalid IPs as well. For now, I am entering 192.168.1.20. You press the tab button, it will automatically enter the subnet mask. Now I will I just don't think so that I need to fill up the rest of these that is default gateway, proper DNS server, alternate DNS server. Just leave it here like that. So now we are at PC2, and I will do the same here at this PC as well, but I would enter a different IP, but not totally different, but similar. And let me just show you here. Doing the same exact things, properties. If you remember, at the PC1, I entered 192.168.1.20. But this would make these both both addresses of this PC the same. As we know in our daily life, the different residences can't have the same address. So we would try something different, a little different but similar. So this is here 21. We press the tab button again and press OK. Now our PCs are connected to each other. Now as you want to share this E drive, so what I would do, I would access the properties of this drive, and then I will access the sharing tab here, and I would then go into the advanced settings, advanced sharing. Make sure you mark this share this folder, and in permissions, it is up to you how much control you want to give it to the other PC user. Right now, I'm giving it a full control so that when the other guy accesses this drive, he has a full he/she has full control over it. He can delete the data, he can read it, he can modify the data, whatever he wants. Okay, so if I unmark this full control, and if I just mark the read, so that you just don't want to let other users ruin your data and other users modify your data, so this option is meant for you then. But right now I'm using a full control option, so I'm applying it here. Okay. Sometimes user get a problem with the security when they access it from the other user, it gives some kind of error. Make sure that you have added everyone to here in a security group of users who can access your PC. If it is not added, what you will do, you will go into the advanced settings, and then you will change permissions, you will add, and again you will access the advanced menu, and you will find with whom you want to share your data with. So there would be everyone here like this, and if the everyone user is not added into your security, then you will click the OK button. But right now I'm not going to do that, as everyone is already added there. So this is it. Now I'm going back to the other PC.
So now we are almost done.
Now access the start menu and type /, and the IP of the PC one, that is 192.168.1.20. You click this button, you will get your e drive share, the drive you have shared. I click this, and this is my data at the other PC now. And for example, I want to copy a movie, Fury 6. Let's copy this, Control C, and I can even cut this folder now, as you know, I have given a full control this to this PC user. Now cross this session and Control V. Now you can see this is a 930 MB data, and it is transferring the data at 10 MB per second speed. Now if you share your data via Wi-Fi, it will transfer your data at 1 MB transfer speed. So that is a kind of very slow thing. So I would suggest you share your data via networking cable. So this is how it works. Thanks for watching our video, and please subscribe our subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment if you have any problems. We would be very, very keen to help your problems. Thank you very much.